Ellie says vitamin K2, MK4, and MK7 might have caused prolonged heart palpitations. Upon stopping it, symptoms mostly resolved after a week or so. Can that mean that the body is better off without it? Might increase in calcium intake mitigate this? And then there's a link. Okay, I can't look at the link now because there's the number of questions in the Q&A goes up, not down over time. So I would say the calcium is really interesting. I genuinely hadn't thought of that until you mentioned it. Even though I've heard other people ask this question, I haven't had time to look into it. But you raise a good point. So it is conceivable, for example, that your bone density has been very low because you have not had the K2 you needed to get the minerals into the bone. And so when you get the K2, you start loading the calcium into the bone. But maybe because your system, your whole body is programmed to assume things were the way they were before you started taking the K2, that it doesn't adapt fast enough to normalize your blood calcium. Which, by the way, how do you normalize your blood calcium? You take calcium out of the bone. So if you have something making calcium go into the bone, oh, by the way, depending on the dose, right? So MK4 has been studied in high milligram doses as an osteoporosis drug because it inhibits bone resorption. If you inhibit bone resorption, you will definitely interfere with your ability to maintain normal serum calcium levels because bone resorption is how you do that. So either you're giving the nutrients needed to get the calcium into the bone and the body is just prioritizing that because it's been missing them for so long and your serum calcium drops, or you're actually creating signaling stopping bone resorption, and so your blood calcium drops because of that. Either way, taking calcium might impact that. And I would love to have some anecdotal data on that because there's no studies on K2 and heart palpitations. There's just a bunch of anecdotes. So I would love it if we had some anecdotes of people saying whether the calcium helps, especially since so much of the K2 stuff is so skeptical of calcium. Kate Ream Blue's book, Vitamin K2 and the Calcium Paradox, I think it's a great book. Basically what that book is an enormous elaboration of my 2007 article on Activator X and Weston Price. But if I had written that book, I would have done things a little bit differently. I think the whole idea of the calcium paradox that's in the title is, I think it has merit. There is some data indicating that calcium supplements might worsen the risk of heart disease, but I think that the conclusions are I think they're way too anti-calcium. And I think there's too many people out there taking K2 who have it in their heads that calcium supplements are bad. And look, calcium supplements are bad compared to getting enough calcium from food. But a huge portion of those people are not getting enough calcium from food. And getting calcium is more important than where it comes from. I genuinely believe that.